look at how your accumulators fire. So particularly accumulator four, okay, which is left arm to right shoulder. So the way the left arm works across the chest as well. Mm. Now if you get to the top of the backswing and all you did was slide hips,
yeah,
then it would look like this. So P6 would happen eventually,
yeah,
but everything would start tilting back.
Yeah.
This hasn't really sort of changed too much.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got to the top of the swing and you fired accumulator four a little bit earlier, shaft would get parallel sooner,
yeah,
and the body wouldn't tilt back as much, and the hips wouldn't move back, they'd slid forward quite as much. Yeah?
Yeah.
So if you're hanging on to things, the shaft has got to be lowered at some point on the club head, so you're going to find ways,
yeah,
of doing that. Because if you were releasing it, let's say you're releasing it very early with a wrist, and then,
yeah,
that's more your move, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it's sort of like wrists, historically the wrists,
yeah,
would go, then the hips would go,
yeah,
but the arms wouldn't do much.
Yeah.
So what we're trying to get you to do pre-shot is to get a feel of, get the transition the way you want it, a little bit of movement forward with the hips, and then start to engage the arms a little bit more. So that movement, when I say to you, get the butt of the club sort of level with the belt buckle, and you mentioned feeling like you were pushing,
yeah,
down on the handle.
Yeah.
That's your wrist angles.
Yeah.
Yeah? It's pushing down on the handle. What you also mentioned was you were straightening your right arm.
Yeah.
And that inserts speeding up the left arm, isn't it?
Yeah.
So they're all feels that are derived from that. Again,
yeah,
that same checkpoint. P6, butt of the club level with, or at least ultimately with you hitting a shot, we want P6, the butt of the club, to be on the right thigh. Certainly moving towards the right thigh.
Yeah.
Pre-shot, we want the butt of the club to be level with the belt.
Yeah.
Yeah?